Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the property that we are observing in the periodic table, and that is electronegativity. So what is electronegativity? Let us talk about it. So first of all, let us see that what is actually electronegativity. It is the ability of an atom in a compound to attract the shared electrons of a chemical, mostly covalent bond, towards itself. That kind of property is known as electronegativity. Let me tell you by giving this with an example. Suppose if we have a compound like HCl, and in this case HCl, as you know that HCl is a compound that consists of a covalent bond, and in this covalent bond, as we could see that it has two electrons, because each bond is made up of two electrons. But among this thing, H is usually partially positive, while Cl, it is partially negative. The sign on this is because of the electronegativity itself, because the chlorine, this atom has a tendency to accept electron from the shared pair of electron. So as you could see that the electrons which are been shared now with H, that is hydrogen atom and Cl atom, but in this case the chlorine atom will share this kind of electron towards itself more. So now in this case the chlorine will have a kind of attraction of the electron which is now with the hydrogen atom towards itself. So that's the reason, because chlorine individually has one electron, but because of its property to attract the electron of the other atom which is present in a compound towards itself, that makes the chlorine to be more negative, and hence we could see that chlorine consists of a partially negative charge when it has been combined with hydrogen so as to form HCl as a compound. So therefore this property of chlorine is known as electronegativity. So talking about this thing, we could also talk it about hydrogen fluoride, that is HF, and talking about HF, we could also mix all the halogens that we have talked about, that is it might be hydrogen halide like HF, HCl or HBr. In these three cases the halogen atoms are basically highly electronegative compared to the other atoms that are, or other elements that are being present in the periodic table. So that makes the fluorine to be the highest electronegative atom when it has been combined with any other element or any other element's atom so as to form a compound. So therefore chlorine is now the more electronegative, and meanwhile we could also say that the hydrogen is more electropositive because it has the tendency to lose electrons, and that tendency to lose electron, it will be that electrons will move towards the chlorine, and hence that's the reason they have acquiring a positive charge. So therefore this positive charge is because of the hydrogen has a tendency to repel the electron towards the chlorine. So that makes the chlorine to be highly electronegative in this case, while the hydrogen atom to be electropositive in this case. So this was the meaning of electronegativity. So talking about more about what is actually electronegativity, let us talk about this thing, and that is electronegativity is a qualitative measure of the ability of an atom in a compound to attract shared electrons of a chemical bond towards itself. So it is a basically a qualitative measurement of the ability. Qualitative measurement of the ability, it means that it will depend on what atom we are concerned about. For example, when we are talking about hydrogen fluoride, or when we have taken an example of an hydrogen fluoride, in that case the fluoride ions, or we could say that the fluorine atom has the more tendency to attract electron from the shared pair of electrons towards itself. So therefore this is a quality measurement of the ability of an atom to attract electrons when they are in a compound form. So this is the one that has been clear, and now moving towards the next one. It is not a measurable quantity but obtained from numerical scales of electronegativity. So this numerical scales of electronegativity are have been derived by the scientists like Pauli scale, they have named the scale as polyscale, because this gives an analysis that what would be the electronegativity of a particular atom when it has been combined with other atoms so as to form a compound. So polyscale or might be Mulliken's Jaffe scale. So this were the scales that could have measured or that could have predicted that what would be the electronegativity of a particular atom when it has been combined with other atom to form a compound. So this gives a roughly idea that what would be the electronegativity of that particular atom. So, but it cannot be measured, it would be compared. We can compare this by using the scales like polyscale and Mulliken Jaffe scale. So talking about the next one, the electronegativity of any given element is not constant and depends upon the element to which it is bound in a compound. Yes, this is also true, because electronegativity value of, for example, if I would say for fluorine, it won't be constant. How? For example, if I'm talking about an example like hydrogen fluoride and an example like methyl fluoride. So these are the two examples in which we could see that the fluoride ion atoms is been common in both the cases. So in this case, basically the hydrogen, which is said to be a partially positive charge, while the fluorine atom will have partially negative charge. While in this case also the methyl molecule will have partially positive charge, while this fluorine atom will have partially negative charge. But the electronegativity of fluorine in this case would be different than that of in this case, because as we could see that the hydrogen is a is an atom which has the capability to lose electron. So that is the reason this will make the hydrogen to be more positive, and meanwhile it will make the fluorine to be more electronegative. So that is what it will make the fluorine to be more electronegative. So therefore the condition of the electronegativity in case of HF will be different than that of the CH3CF, because CH3CF is a group of atoms, or basically you could say a group which has a tendency to give electrons, or basically we could say it as it has positive inductive effect. So it will give up the electrons towards the fluorine, and again the fluorine will have the tendency to become more electronegative. But it depends on the compound that we are talking about. But since we also know that fluorine is the most electronegative compound in the whole periodic table, but rather than that, we should also know that it depends on the fluorine to which group or to which atom it has been attached to, so as to form a particular covalent bond or so as to form a basic compound. So it depends. So talking about this thing, we could also predict or also take an example of HCl, or might be CH3Cl, C2H5Cl. So in that case also the electronegativity would be different. And talking about the other example, if I would say like H2O, so in this case also, as you could see that the oxygen is the more electronegative compound in case of when we compare it with hydrogen. So in this case the oxygen has a tendency to attract electrons of the hydrogen, of both the hydrogen, towards itself. So this makes the hydrogen to be more electronegative, and as a result of this, this acquires partially negative charge, while the hydrogen acquires partially positive charge. So this is what when it comes to H2O molecule. But we could also take an example of like alcohol, as we could see. In alcohol also this oxygen has been present, but the groups are different. In this case the hydrogen is attached, but in this case the CH3 is also attached. So that makes the value of this oxygen's electronegativity would be different than that of the oxygen which is in water molecule. So the both will be different. So that is what the point it was they were saying, that electronegativity of a given element is not constant and depends upon the element to which it is bound in a compound. So let us move on further. So it says that it gives an idea about electropositivity and electronegativity character of a particular compound, as well as it also gives a detail about what would be the metallic and non-metallic property of elements. Continuation. Because as we have compared with the hydrogen and chlorine when they are forming hydrogen chloride, and in that case the chlorine atoms are to be more electronegative compared to that of the hydrogen. And in that case also what we have got to know that hydrogen is more electropositive, means it has a tendency to lose electrons to the chlorine atom, which makes the chlorine atom to be more electronegative in a compound. So similarly, the hydrogen makes itself more electropositive, while the chlorine makes itself more electronegative while attracting the electron from the hydrogen. So this ability of the chlorine makes it more electropositive, but meanwhile it makes the hydrogen to be more electropositive. This makes the chlorine to be more electronegative, while for the hydrogen it is more electropositive. So this will be in any case. Suppose if we have compared a atom which is more electronegative, then moreover we could see that the other element which has been attached to it forming a covalent bond will be electropositive. And it depends that how much it will be electropositive. It will depend on the electronegative atom or the electropositive atom. So the bond also depends on both the things, so as to make whether the bond is ionic or whether the bond is covalent. So talking about the next thing, it also gives us the detail of whether it is a metallic bond or a metallic property or a non-metallic property. Because when it comes to metallic property, metals are those which give up their electrons very easily, or which lose their electrons very easily, so as to form a positive charged atom. So this is the property of a metal. So metal has a tendency to lose electrons, while in case of non-metals has a tendency to accept electrons, or we could say that most of the non-metals are more electronegative compared to that of metal. So therefore this also gives a characteristics of a metal and a non-metal when a bond is been formed. So this is what electronegativity helps out for us to determine the difference between that, which one would be electropositive, which one would be electronegative, which one would form a covalent bond, which one would form a more polar covalent bond, and etc. So that is what I have talked here. That is, it helps to predict the properties like bond strength, bond polarity, ionic character of a covalent bond. Even covalent bond can form ionic character. For example, when we are talking about hydrogen fluoride, in this case both the atoms are non-metals. So we know that two non-metals forms a basically covalent bond. But in this case, since the fluorine is being more electronegative, so that makes the fluorine to attract the electron of the hydrogen toward itself, making the fluorine to be more partially negative. And talking about the hydrogen, it will be more positive. So this kind of charge difference or this kind of polarity that we see in a covalent bond results in a formation of ionic character that we could see in a covalent bond. So even this can be predicted by the help of the electronegativity. And moreover, the bond strength also is been can be predicted, because of which we could say that that compound can be easily soluble, or that bond can be easily breakable. So that is what it gives us a brief idea. And talking about bond polarity is the same, nothing but the difference in the positive charge and the negative charge that forms in a covalent bond or any kind of bond. So because of the help of electronegativity, we could predict this all data, and that would be very much beneficial for us to understand for a particular compound or the chemistry of a particular compound or an element. So this is what the electronegativity is. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood the concept of electronegativity more and much more better. So share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to EKTA channel. Thank you so much.